Hey fellow animators, I'm Miloš Černý, and today we are going to continue with creating rig and skin in 3ds Max CAD for this 3D model of a humanoid mech. This is part 2 of the series, so if you didn't watch the first part, it would probably be better to watch that first. But let's get going. We will continue exactly where we finished in the last part. I got this model from Rudy Baldi, as you probably already heard, but go check out his website to see more stuff he did. So, we completed the rig in the last video, let's start skinning. Apply skin modifier and add all the bones. Just the bones though, not helpers. You can create a motion layer just to test out if the skin was applied and that everything works fine. After that, we have to create our skin testing animation. I will speed up this part quite a bit, because it is kind of a boring process. Basically, you should animate every single bone in every single way possible for that bone, so you can see the deformations when you are skinning the mesh. Okay, so I am done with the animation, but I forgot to do the toes, so I am adding them now. However, I can already see that I don't like the placement of this bone. The pivot is quite high and is not in the proper place. In part 1, I also mentioned I forgot to place elbow bone correctly. Both of these things need to be fixed, and I have done a separate video for that, which you can find below the video. Basically, you just turn off Always Deform and the whole skin modifier after that. You can see that the animation is still intact, but the mesh is not moving, because the skin modifier is disabled. Now, in setup mode, we can reposition the bone. When done, copy the bone to the other leg as well. Select mesh and reactivate the skin modifier. You can see that the joint works much better this way. Okay, so let's start with actual skinning. Disable the texture on the model so we can see the weights better, or just apply a blank texture to it. Set bone effect limit to 4 and start skinning. This model is quite specific because it's a mechanical character, so many of its parts will have 100% values for that particular bone, which means that select element checkbox will be quite useful for selections, as well as grow button. You can see I'm just adding 100% values to all vertices belonging to calf and ankle. Looks like toes worked out quite alright with the default values, and not much to fix there. This part can be softened up a bit so it doesn't overlap that much with the foot. With knees, I decided that I am not going to deform the mesh and I will try to do it with 100% values and see how it looks. So lower meshes are going to lower leg bone, upper meshes to the upper leg bone. Of course with CAD, the bones might sometimes rotate like this, which I don't mind, and I don't like to lock them in certain axes, because I don't like to limit the movement possibilities. I will fix them manually if that happens, like I did here. I also don't like to use look at constraint bones for setting up rotations of knees, unless I have to, because with constraints you are kind of limiting the use of saving and loading clips in CAD. It can work, but it complicates things, so if I don't have to, I animate them manually. I realized that just 100% values won't work in poses like these, so I will soften them up a bit, but to the point so it doesn't break the feeling of hard surface. You can see that I even reapply the texture back to see how it looks, I will be doing that several times during the whole process. Okay, so continue to the upper leg. You can see that I am adding poses to the skin test animation if I feel I am missing something. I added more extreme pose for when the leg is back to see how the butt and upper thigh are deforming. I am switching between upper leg and pelvis all the time and checking how the leg is deforming. Here I again reapply the texture to see where the soft parts are that can deform a bit more and which parts should stay as solid as possible. Don't forget to look at the whole mesh from different angles. Sometimes things look alright until you rotate the camera. I decided this whole hinge should be part of just the upper leg. However, here I was trying to figure out if it is possible to skin the way it wouldn't clip into the body mesh. I have tried more variations, but decided it has to be fixed in the mesh. I went back to editable poly modifier and added this particular loop so it matches with the edge of the hinge. This solved the problem because I was able to weigh that loop on the upper leg to prevent that clipping. We are still not done with the leg though. I am removing the weight of the leg for vertices that it doesn't need. Also adding 100% values to pelvis for vertices I am sure belong just to the pelvis. Back thigh and butt are usually one of the harder parts to skin on most humanoid models, so you can see I will spend quite some time with them until I feel okay with the result and move to the spine. Spine looks actually pretty good, even with the default values. There are some parts that are stretching even though they are metal parts, but not much we can do with it. This part, however, can be done a bit better. This doesn't need to move with the leg. You can see it is much better now and it doesn't move that much. Okay, so we have legs and most of the torso done. Arms and head remain and we will take a look at those in the next part. If you would like to see more stuff like this Hiroshima mech model and more free content for everybody, support me on Patreon or with any other way you would prefer, or just share the video. Thank you. I am Miloš Černý and thank you for watching.